Students, coming to the next topic, that is divide and conquer. So what is this divide and conquer? The name is indicating that we have to divide something and we have to combine something. So what is that? What we have to divide and what we have to combine? So let us see. A divide and conquer is a very important strategy in computer science. So whatever the concept you have taken, that the programming languages or whatever related to the computer science, this divide and conquer is a very important strategy. So what are the steps that are involved in divide and conquer? The first, we have to divide problem. So whatever the problem we are taken, first you have to divide that problem into smaller parts. Okay, you have taken some array and you are divided that array into smaller parts. Second, so independently solve that parts. Next, you have to do independently solve that parts. So whatever the array you have taken, that array should be divided into two parts. Two or more part means divide problem into smaller parts. Again, you have to solve them independently. So you have to solve them independently. So after solving independently, you will get the solution for independent part. Then combine these solution to get overall solution. So that is a strategy you have to follow in the divide and conquer. So whenever first take a problem, divide the problem into smaller parts, solve the smaller parts problem independently, and combine the solution, whatever the solution you get for the independent parts, combine the solution to get the overall solution. So these are the steps that are involved in the divide and conquer. So let me explain with diagrammatic. So first take the problem. So just take the problem. Let the problem size is n. Means the size of the problem is, this is like n. Okay. So what I have to do? I have to divide the problem into smaller problems, smaller parts. So just I am dividing into two halves. This is sub problem 1 of size. So actually the problem size is n, but I divided the problem into half. So the size becomes n by 2. This is sub problem 1. And this is another sub problem 2 of size n by 2. Okay, now the problem is divided into two smaller parts. Now, after dividing the problem, what we have to do? We have to solve that problem. We have to solve that problem. Now, solve it. After solving, you will get the solution to subproblem 1. For this also, after solving, I get the solution to subproblem 2. So I get the solutions to subparts. Now combine all the solutions and get the overall solution. So this is a solution to original problem. Original problem. Okay. So these are the steps that are involved in the divide and conquer. So first we have to divide the problem. Divide the problem. So after dividing, you have to solve the problem independently. Solve the problem. Solve the, you call it as a sub problem or else. Solve the sub problem. After solving the sub problem, you have to combine to get the original solution. Okay. So this, up to here, this stage is divide stage. This is divide stage. And this is the conquer stage. conquer stage. You call it as this is solving the sub problem is a conquer stage. After that, this is a combine. This is the combine stage. Okay, so this is the concept of the divide and conquer. Okay, so let me tell you some ideas to solve the divide and conquer problems. The first idea one. So in the idea one, they are decided, we are decided that divide the array. So whatever the problem, that is the array you have taken, into two halves. Okay. After that, recursively sort left and right values, right halves. So whenever I divided the problem into two halves, okay, divide the array into two halves. So one becomes the left side and another becomes the right side. So this is the left half and the right half. So first divide the problem into two halves. After that, you have to recursively sort the left and right halves. So after recursively sorting, then merge two halves. So this you call it as a merge sort. So this is the technique of merge sort. So the merge sort will divide the array into two halves and recursively sort the left half and the right half. Again, it combines to and merge the two halves. Merge means combining the two halves. So this is one idea. And the next idea for divide and conquer, to implement the divide and conquer method, partition array into small items. So first you have to partition the array into small items and large items. So just take all the small items and take the large items into separate groups. Then recursively sort the two sets. So this technique you call it as a quick sort. So these are the most important techniques, the examples for the divide and conquer method. So the difference here you can observe is, in this idea merge sort, we are just dividing the array into two halves and we are recursively sorting left and right half. Whereas in merge sort, we are just partitioning the array of small items and the large items. So here the small and large items we are taken, but here we are just dividing left and right. So small items have to recursively sort and large items should be recursively sort. After that, you have to combine the two sets. So these are the two ideas that were implemented in the divide and conquer. So let me write the examples for the divide and conquer. So examples, what are the examples for divide and conquer method? So first one is searching. Searching is one example for the divide and conquer. So we will take the binary search. To explain this search technique, I'll take the binary search. And the second is sorting. And the sorting also we will use the divide and conquer method. So the sorting, the examples for the merge sort and quick sort. Next, tree traversal. So in the tree traversal technique also, we will use the divide and conquer methods. And the fourth one is matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication. So the example for this matrix multiplication is Tressman algorithm. Tressman's algorithm. Okay. So these are the examples for the divide and conquer method. So let me discuss one by one the examples of this divide and conquer. First, I'll explain about the binary search in the next video. Thank you.